Okay, we're back with the installation of the U-joints. Now we press this in and you can see that there is enough of a gap right here exposed, and this is going to hopefully allow us to install our clip, the first one. So it goes right in there, and I'm going to try to just press it in there. Boom. So that's one. Now we have to do the same thing with the other side, but you see that it's not yet exposed. This cap is still a little bit out, so we are going to give it a little bit more pressing. And if you notice, this tool has a lot of marks. Some of this is because people have forced it and dented this up. This is typical rental equipment, and so it may not ride on there 100% even, so we're going to get it on there as even as we possibly can. And we're going to drive that cap on there. That does not feel good. I'm sorry, that does not feel good. What we're going to do is we are going to give this a little bit of a hit, and what we're going to do is we are going to support it right here underneath here and here, and then we are going to try to tap this so that this moves a little bit. In other words, we're going to push that up against that clip. We're going to do that very carefully. The wood. Centered. So that's close. But there's still not enough room to put that in there. And we're hoping that that will be giving us a little bit more don't know if that is enough. Okay, I need to put that in the box. All right, we've got this locked into the vise again, and we're gonna try to put that clip in there. This one's not going in there as easy because it doesn't seem to be as much space. And if we can get this driven in there, then that would be nice. And then most of the way. Oh, wow, look at that. Not bad. So, yep, that's seated. So, got both those in there. That's nice and loose, but we still want to give a little bit of push on this to put pressure on this. And that's so that this clip is as tight up against the yoke as possible. Now, if you had one of those needle bearings sideways, it would be extremely difficult to get that cap in there deep enough to put that clip on. And they would not go, it would not rock this easily. This is what you want, nice and smooth, but hopefully it's gonna get even smoother once we go ahead and hit on this. So we're gonna take it back to the blocks of wood. About the same, but I think we're going to call that good. So now we put this into the other end of the drive shaft. But before we want to do that, we're going to pack this up with a little bit of grease. So one of these holes doesn't matter because they all connect in the center. And we're just going to press on that. I think we're packing a bearing. That's got a fair amount of pressure on it. I can feel that. And then put the drive shaft into the vise. If you don't have a vise, it's just problem trying to pull all this stuff together, but it is possible. This might take a tap also. This is amazingly, this one didn't need any kind of tap to get that crossing there. So we're going to push this out to put that cap on there. And then push it in there all the way. I'm gonna give it a little bit of a tap. Now we're putting pressure going this way because we wanna try to make sure that that stays right there on that cap. So for now. Now, the other side, we're gonna move this out. Make it as even as possible. Put that cap in there. Line it up. And you can already see some of the needle bearings trying to come out right there. So we gotta make sure that we are like mid-seated. Give this just a little bit of a tap. Sure, could seat this. The grease is creating a little bit of a vacuum. Okay, we have the press back in the vise, and we hopefully have this mid-seated. I'm going to have to raise this up some more since this cap is not in there anywhere near as deep as the last one. Get that close. With a tension on it. It's good, that'll stay. I want to make sure this is in there even. If you're using an impact, you can't get the same feel. It's easy to just totally over torque it. So make sure this is, you can see this is not exactly centered, so I'm gonna just center it. Pretty good for that side. Oops. Okay. Well, that actually doesn't look too bad. This side is in there, so we are going to work on that clip. Boom, this side went in really good. Other side. Okay, teachable moment here. What I noticed was, even though this groove looks like it's exposed, that is not the groove that we really want. And I'll show you on this other set of U-joints here. This is where I just pointed the clip. Go in there like that, and it should go in to the next groove. So I pulled that clip out, and we need to drive these in a little bit more. You can see this groove here, right next to the rubber, is not the groove that we want. Just like on this, right next to the rubber, is not what we want. We want it. What we're seeing is something like that. We could call it a false groove. So anyway, we are going to drive this in a little bit more.
much as I dare put pressure on.
Enough of a groove to try. Enough of a groove exposed. That looks good. Okay, go to the other side.